In the present session, I'll cover fiber channel architecture. The FC architecture represents true channel or network integration and captures some of the benefits of both channel as well as network technology. FCSAN uses the fiber channel protocol, that is FCP, that provides both channel speed for data transfer with low protocol overhead and scalability of network technology. So FC architecture represents a network integration or a channel which combines the benefits of both channel as well as network technology. The fiber channel protocol forms the fundamental construct of FCSAN infrastructure. The key advantages of FCP are as follows. The first advantage is sustained transmission bandwidth over longer distance, which also supports for a large number of addressable devices over a network. So that means we can improve scalability. The speed may be up to 16 gigabits per second. So in the diagram, it shows fiber channel protocol stack, that is FCP stack. Here we can observe that we are having four layers like FC0, FC1, FC2 and FC4. FC0, which indicates the physical interface. FC1 is encode and decode part. FC2 is it performs framing and flow control. And FC4 consisting of upper layer protocol mapping. So here we can consider some upper layer protocols like SCSI, HIPPI, ESCON, ATM and IP. FC upper layer protocol. FC4 is the uppermost layer in the FCP stack, which defines the application interfaces and the way upper layer protocols are mapped to the lower FC layers. So FC layer 4, so that is FC4 upper layer, which defines some set of protocols that can operate on FC4 layer. So like SESI, HIPPI framing protocol, that means high performance peripheral interface protocol, and enterprise storage connectivity, that is ESCON, and ATM, like means asynchronous transfer mode, and IP. So next is FC2 transport layer. So FC2 is a transport layer that contains the payload addresses of the source and destination ports and link control informations. So basically FC2 transport layer consisting of the payload as well as addresses of the source and the destination ports followed by link control informations. The FC2 layer provides fiber channel addressing, structure and organization of the data. So that means whether the data can be transmitted in terms of frames or in sequences and how exactly we can exchange the frames between any two devices. So it also defines fabric services, classes of service like class A, class B, like that, flow control as well as routing. The major responsibilities of FC2 transport layers are it contains payload as well as address of the source as well as destination and link control informations. So it also provides fiber channel addressing structure and organization of the data. It also defines fabric service, classes of service, flow control as well as how exactly the frames can be routed. So last one is FC0 is the lowest layer in the FCP stack. So this layer defines the physical interface, media and transmission of raw bits. So the FC0 layer defines the physical interface, media and transmission of raw bits. The FC0 specification includes the cables, connectors and optical and electrical parameters for a variety of data rates. The FC transmission can use both electrical and optical media. So next we'll take fiber channel addressing. So the FC addresses is dynamically assigned when a port locks onto the fabric. So that means the FC address can be dynamically assigned. It can be dynamically assigned when a port locks onto the fabric. So the FC address has a distinct format that varies according to the type of node port in the fabric. The assigned FC fiber channel address has a distinct format and it varies depending upon the type of the ports in the fabric. So these ports can be either N port, NL port, that means node port, node loop port, or in a public loop, or NL port in the private loop. So the first field of FC address of an N port contains the domain ID of the switch. So initially the first field of the FC address of an N port contains a domain ID, and this is an 8-bit field. Out of the possible 256 domain IDs, so we can use 239 are available for use. The remaining 17 addresses are reserved for specific services. So we'll be having 2^8, that is 256 domain IDs. Out of 256, we can use only 239 domain IDs. So 256 minus 239, so we can 17 addresses are reserved for specific services. For example, FFFFC is reserved for the name server, and FFFFE is reserved for the fabric login service. The maximum possible number of N ports in a switched fabric is calculated as, suppose if you are having 239 domain IDs into 256 area IDs into 256 ports, so you'll get the value is around 15,663.104 fiber channel addresses. So the maximum possible number of N ports in a switched fabric, so that is around 15,663.104 fiber channel addresses. So in the diagram we can observe that we are having the domain IDs, area ID and port ID. So here we are having for N port, how we can specify the ID. So we are having the domain ID as 01, and domain ID is, this is 01, and we are having the area ID as 3 and port as 00. So we can specify the N port ID as domain ID, area ID and the port ID. So this will be assigned after the device is locked into the fabric. So similarly for domain 2, I can have the ID as 02, 06 and 00. So here we can observe that the FC address is assigned to nodes during fabric login, used for communication between nodes within FC SAN. The address format, as I specified, it consisting of domain ID, area ID as well as the port ID. So I can calculate the domain ID. I can have the domain ID is a unique number provided to each switch in the fabric. So out of 256, I can use only 239 addresses and other 17 addresses will not be used. So this is nothing but 239 into 256 area ID, 256 port ID. So this is the actual value, 15663104. So that is the maximum possible number of node ports in a switched fabric. So next is worldwide names. Each device in the FC environment is assigned a 64-bit unique identifier called as worldwide name. The fiber channel environment uses two types of worldwide names, like worldwide node name and worldwide port name. Unlike an FC address, which is assigned dynamically, a worldwide name is a static name for each device on an FC network.